is your boss watching you while you work from home? For those of you who aren't wearing pants and working from home, you have a whole other set of problems to be dealing with right now. We turn to business strategist and leadership specialist Sherry Perry for this one. Good morning, Sherry. How are you?
Oh, I'm having a great time listening to your music and your humor.
Well, excellent. I'm glad somebody is. So this has kind of been a big thing ever since this pandemic thing started. Working from home, we all knew it was going to come with some side effects, if you will. And one of those is that most laptops or tablets have a camera on the front of them, and they've got some prying eyes. A lot of times, though, it's the companies that are watching, but it might not just be the cameras. They're also watching mouse movements and keyboard strokes as well, from what I understand.
They are. There are lots of tools out there to help businesses determine, are you engaged? Are you working when you say you're working? So, yeah, there's lots and lots of tools out there.
So what do folks need to know? What do they need to be aware of? And what do they need to make sure that they're doing?
Well, A, put your pants on if you have the camera on. So let's start with that. That was hilarious, by the way. Super funny. Businesses to make sure that they're lining out these policies and that the people that are taking their technology home, whether it's phones, tablets, computers, that they know what you're going to be monitoring. Because there's certainly some privacy issues around the fact that if you're watching somebody or monitoring what they're doing and they don't know, that's not cool. From an employee standpoint, I would say do everything you can to make it where somebody doesn't have to wonder what you're doing. Right?
Suspicious minds, if you will. Cue up the Elvis, because there we go on that one. I mean, so
exactly.
What would be some of those suspicions?
Well, you know, it's very, even before COVID, even before we had more of our workforce working from home, there was already a lack of engagement in the workplace, Mark, and so it's very natural to think that once they're out of your sight, that your team members may become even more disengaged. But I would like to submit for everybody listening that if you've hired the right people, you have people that are hired in alignment with your mission and your values, and you set up some really great game rules as far as, hey, here's the productivity that we expect while you're at home and you help people be successful, you probably don't have to resort to surveillance.
Mm-hmm. So, I mean, there is a certain amount of trust that has to go along with from the employer, right? Like, I mean, there should be a level of trust with all of this between employer and employee.
Absolutely. And, you know, trust is something that's earned over time. It's also something that an employee can absolutely earn fairly quickly by doing things like if I have a staff member that's working remotely and they tell me more than I ask them, you know, hey, Sherry, here was my day. This is what I got done. These are the challenges that I faced. And is there anything else that I can do for you or something along those lines? Man, I'm going to trust that staff member.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Why would you have any reason not to? Right. I mean, I guess
exactly.
That's the big question. And I think a lot of employees, of course, then again, when you start looking at productivity levels and you start looking at, I would imagine like different generations look at this differently as well. That's probably a big section of this.
Well, there's definitely a generational component to it. I would say that from a business leader standpoint, if you clarify what you expect. I mean, a lot of people think that they get paid for the hour that they work, and that's just not true.
Right.
People get paid for the value that they bring to that hour. And so if you're a staff member and your boss can't get you on the phone, you didn't show up to the meeting or you're late,
right,
or any of those things that happen, especially in a remote scenario, yeah, you're breaking trust.
Right.
Well, and they're not going to know what you're doing.
And in a sense, I mean, really the only difference between working at home and working from the office is the location. Everything else should remain the same for the most part, right? I mean, your habits should remain the same. Your productivity should remain the same.
Exactly. I mean, we see these funny memes on Facebook that say, hey, I washed all my pajamas and got all my work clothes done for the week. And that's real funny. But if you have staff members that aren't taught, listen, get up. on time. Get dressed like you're going to work. Be right. in the office, even if you're at home.
Right.
You can really help people be more productive at home.
I was talking to a friend of mine who was, he as well spent 11 or 12 weeks working from home. And one of the things that he did was every morning, he got up and he got dressed like he was going for work. He actually got in his car. He would drive down to Starbucks or the coffee shop and get a cup of coffee and come back. And that would be his trip back and forth to work, essentially. So kind of the
routines do help us.
Yeah, the little things that you can do to kind of, you know, keep yourself in that same schedule of mind, at least for your normal workday. My guest this morning, business strategist and leadership specialist, Sherry Perry. Sherry, we always appreciate the time. We'd love to have you back soon.
Sounds great. Thanks, Mark.
You got to take care.